honest with me. What is the real reason why you're single right now?
Simple. It's because people don't respect your time. I literally just drove an hour away from my house to come see a girl that I've been talking to for a good, 2 weeks. We've FaceTimed, called, texted a bunch. We connect really well. And I drive out here to come see her after yesterday. She bailed on me yesterday because of work. And I come out tonight anyways. And, nothing. Doesn't say anything. I drove an hour for nothing.
Who's all been there before with women? I know I have a lot in the past, but I learned my lesson. And I figure out what was going wrong in the situation, interaction with women leading up to the date, the hangout, the meetup. So I don't want you guys to be jaded and frustrated and angry and say, man, all these females are for the streets. All these chicks, all they do is waste time. All they're about is just stringing you along, getting your attention and all these different things. There are some things that he could have did that would have prevented him from being in that situation, making that video. Now I noticed he said, and I quote, we FaceTimed a lot. We talked, we text for 2 weeks. That's far too long for you to be communicating with the woman and talking. So the first thing he did was give his attention all to her, all that non-sexual attention. He just gave it to her for free. Cause he thought, okay, I like the girl. Clearly the communication is going good. The sparks are probably flying. The attraction is clearly there. And then you guys just communicating, going back and forth every hour of the day. At night, he probably texts her, good morning, beautiful. How's your day going? Good night. I'm thinking about you, all this stuff. And she's going back and forth. She's reciprocating the same energy. But then when it comes down to time to hang out, she cuts contact. She ghosts you. She's non-existent. She stops communicating, or she gets really flaky. And you're like, that doesn't make any sense. And you look back at the text message and you look at the call log. You're like, we've been talking. Why does she want to hang out? That's because you weren't mysterious. You gave her your hand. You showed her, hey, this is who I am. You gave her too much information before even hanging out with her, before hooking up. So in her mind, she's like, what's the point of me hanging out with him? I know it's messed up as a man. You're probably thinking, that doesn't make any sense. That's how women think. If you give them too much information, if you let them know about you, if you just talk too much to them, you're giving them what they want, which is your non-sexual attention. And on top of that, there's no mystery. So when it's time to hang out, she's like, man, this guy, he's always there. He's always available. What's the point of me even hanging out with them and meeting them if I could just text them all day? If I could just communicate with them? This is why, for the most part, women will flake on you, ghost you, and say, hey, let's just reschedule. Because you gave them too much of your attention. Now you're so available and always there, she doesn't need to hang out with you. On top of that, the next thing he did wrong was he talked for 2 weeks. Guys, once you get a woman's number on a dating app or whether it's approaching in person, you got to set that hangout, that get together, that date for no more than 3 to 4 days out. So let's say hypothetically today is Monday, and you get the number, you set the date up for Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday at the latest. If you go past that 4 day mark, what's going to happen is she's going to just lose attraction. Then another guy's going to come in and he's going to strike when the iron's hot. Remember that. Always strike when the iron's hot. Aside from you being thirsty, needy, clingy, and always available, what's one of the first things women notice when they come into contact with you? I'll give you a second to think. Your face, how well groomed you are, how clean and clear your skin looks. This can make or break the interactions that you have with women. Whether you get that contact information, whether you get that phone number, how you look and how you take care of yourself from the neck up matters. This is why I'm excited to bring you the sponsor of today's video, Tiege Hanley. They have helped me start and maintain my skincare routine by making the entire process uncomplicated, easy, and effortless. Guys, I'm telling you, it is the best skincare product out there. People always ask me, Darius, you look 22, 23, 24. You're not 32, are you? And I tell them, yes, I am. Thanks to Tiege Hanley. A daily face wash to get rid of the dirt and grime on your skin. A 2 times per week exfoliating scrub to get rid of all the dead skin cells. A daily moisturizer with SPF 20 because you should always be protecting your skin from the sun. and a PM moisturizer to help your skin stay healthy and hydrated throughout the night. My favorite part about Tiege Hanley is that every box comes with an instruction card. It tells you how much product to use, when to use it, and in what order. I've been using their products for a while now. Let me tell you, I am absolutely hooked. I look forward to my morning and evening routines because after I wash my face, I feel that much more confident and amazing. In addition to having clean, clear, amazing looking skin, members of Tiege Hanley get other benefits as well. You get to customize your box any way you like, 25% off the retail price. You have the ability to pause or cancel at any time, and you also get free US shipping. And because today's video is being sponsored by Tiege Hanley, all my viewers, yes, that's you, get a great deal. Click the first link in the description box, and you'll not only get Tiege Hanley at the best possible price, but with your first box, you'll get a free gift. Click that link and get started for just $25. Now, the next thing that guy did wrong, and I've done it a handful of times, was drive way out to go see her. He said he drove an hour one way, so that's 2 hours round trip. That is not a good thing to do, especially if that's the first time you guys are meeting, hanging out. You're setting that stage, that foundation, that you're going to be the one that's going to her, that she's the prize, that she's more valuable than you. And subconsciously, you're thinking in your mind, she's going to appreciate me. She's going to really like me now that I take the time. I gas up. I get on the expressway. That's kind of wear and tear on your car. Kind of like the climbing the mountain to get to her, climbing the castle to fight the dragon. You think that she's going to like you more for that? No. She actually sees you as weak. She subconsciously sees you as, this guy don't have any options. Is he that thirsty to come see me? Is he that like desperate? I mean, does he not have any women that like him in his own town, in his own city, that he would drive a whole hour to see me? See, as guys, we don't think like that, but that's how women think. So then when you get there more often than not, and I've been there, she's going to play wishy-washy games. She's not going to try to make things happen physically. She's going to be kind of standoffish. She's going to be making demands. I have women say, hey, could you stop by the store and bring me this? Because they think, okay, well, if he drove an hour away to see me, he can stop at the store and give me this. Then you'll be getting her this. Then you'll be getting her this. Then you'll be investing so much, and she'll be taking advantage of you. This is why, guys, relax on driving far to see women. I can see if you guys been in a relationship and the feelings are mutual and you got a situation where she drives to see you an hour one time, the next time you guys are alternating. That's one thing. But the first time, that reeks desperation, okay? And on top of that, the women that drove to me in the past, hour, 2 hours, sometimes 3 hours, what happened was they were really excited to hang out with me. And I didn't think they were thirsty or weak or needy. Because as men, we don't think that. We just see, oh, she's genuinely interested. But that's how women compute things. I've had women take planes to come see me. Buses, hitchhike, do all type of stuff. Get a ride from somebody. And the situations always flow well. And they weren't on any games. And I wasn't playing with them. So you guys have to be mindful of how you first interact and deal with women, because that's going to set the stage. Now, the next thing that guy did wrong, and I tell you guys, giving these women another opportunity. He said, we're supposed to hang out one day, and then she couldn't do it, so the next day I came. So she flaked on you. She gave you a silly excuse, most likely, and she was lying. And she said, oh, I can't do it, or, and then you came out there anyway the next day and rescheduled. Guess what? She's like, oh, this guy's weak, and she just didn't want to see you. Because going back to the first point, you gave her all that attention. You gave her what she wanted. You were too available, contacted her too much. There was no mystery. And then you're willing to drive way to see her. So in her mind, she thinks you're weak. You don't have any value. You don't have any options in your town, in your city. And on top of that, you're devaluing yourself. Then you're lowering your own value by rescheduling after she flaked on you, after she canceled. Then she's like, okay, well, all right, this guy don't respect himself. So, well, I'm done with him. I don't want to see him now because I flaked on him. And you have to punish women when they cancel and flake. I don't care how good she looks. I don't care how attractive she is. I don't care how much you're into her. If she flakes once, low interest. Just get rid of her, guys. I'm telling you, because if you reschedule, more often than not, 99 times out of 100, she's going to be on some silly game. So when y'all hang out, in her mind, she's like, well, I might as well. All right. So I give him a chance, right? And you're not her number one option because her number one option was the guy that she flaked on you for and went to go hang out. This is how women think. This is how they operate. So guys, relax on being needy. Relax on trying to do too much to show her that you really like her. Stop always communicating, even if it's your girlfriend or wife. You don't have to always text them and talk to them all the time. Because in order for a woman to get hooked on you, she has to be wondering about you when you guys are away. Not always there and you're ready to talk to her and see how she's doing. Don't do any of these mistakes, guys. Learn from this guy. And when you apply these steps, these tips, your successful woman will skyrocket.